हेलो एवरीवन, आई कुलदीप शर्मा वेलकम यू ऑल टू टुडे सेशन ऑन 20 जीके क्वेश्चन विच वी आर स्पेसिफिकली क्यूरेटेड फ्रॉम द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चंस फॉर टुडे। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कंपनीज ऑफ इंडिया हैज द लार्जेस्ट प्राइवेट पोर्ट्स नेटवर्क। सो इफ यू विल लुक एट टुडेज हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर ऑन द वेरी फ्रंट पेज देर इज एन एडवर्टीजमेंट वेयर दिस क्लेम हैज बीन मेड एंड दिस क्लेम हैज बीन मेड बाय विच कंपनी इज द क्वेश्चन। So, which is the largest private ports network company? Is it Adani? Is it Maersk? Is it SR or is it JSW Infrastructure? The answer is A, Adani, which is the largest private ports network of India, company with the largest private ports network. Maersk Link Line Private Limited is actually the world's largest shipping company. It is world's largest shipping company, and you can actually see containers on railway network where you will read this name again and again because it also has a very big supply chain in India also. So first, the answer for first is actually the Adani Ports. Next question. So India has allowed exports of onion to which country despite ban on onion exports? So because of volatility in onion prices, there has been a ban on export of onions since December of 2023. Some people believe, opposition party believes that it is basically so that the prices of onions can be controlled before the Lok Sabha elections, which are going to be held very soon. So that there is no price volatility or some issue regarding onion prices does not become an election issue. That's why there has been a ban on onion export and it is causing a lot of hardship on the onion farmers. However, recently because of foreign relations, India has allowed exports of onion to one of the countries. Which is that country? Is it to Pakistan? Is it Bangladesh? Is it Saudi or is it UAE? So answer here is D, UAE. So India has allowed exports of onion to UAE despite a ban. Next question. So Indira Gandhi Memorial Tulip Garden is the largest tulip garden in Asia. So see, you also get certain facts in the question also. So remember this, that Indira Gandhi Memorial Tulip Garden, wherever it is also the largest tulip garden in Asia. And you have to tell me, where is it located? So is it in Gangtok? Is it in Shimla? Is it in Srinagar? Or is it in Tawang, Arunachal Pradesh? So answer here is C, Srinagar. So if you will look at the today's Hindu newspaper, on the very front page, there is a picture of the tulip garden and below you will find out where it is located. So from there also you can find out questions and other interesting information also. Next question. So the embassy of which of the following country was allegedly targeted by Israel's military in Damascus, Syria's capital? So again, you now know the capital also of Syria, which is Damascus. So embassy of this country was actually allegedly targeted by Israelis, and actually two senior military officials of that country also died. And I have asked you this question because that country whose embassy was targeted has now said that it is going to target Israel's embassy everywhere. So you have to tell me which embassy I am talking about. Was it an Ecuador embassy? Was it Indian embassy? Was it Iranian embassy? Or was it Rwandan embassy? So answer here is C, Iran. So Iranian embassy was allegedly, because it is not foolproof that whether Israeli actually attacked it or not. So allegedly targeted by Israeli military. Next question. So MSME sector or micro, small and medium enterprise, the other sector is the large enterprise sector. So MSME sector is considered as the backbone of Indian industry as it is the largest employment provider also in when it comes to manufacturing sector. So you have to tell me, it has been demanding GST rates. So I'm asking you simply which of the following authority recommends GST rate. So whatever the GST rate is to be decided, which authority decides on the GST rates? Is it the Ministry of Finance? Is it GST Tax Council? Is it Reserve Bank of India? Or is it Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs? So answer here is GST Council, which is actually a constitutional body under Article 279A and consists of Finance Minister as the chairman, Finance Minister of India as chairman, and Finance Ministers of all the state as its member. They together sit and then they decide on the GST rates, various GST rates on different products, and basically recommend it to the central government and the state government, and finally it is implemented by the respective governments only. Next question. So as per a pollution awareness survey, so there was a pollution awareness survey by an NGO in Delhi NCR, wherein it found out that pollution awareness among urban poor in Delhi and NCR area is very low. So my question is, which is the authority which publishes the air quality index? So urban poor in Delhi actually does not know about terms like air quality index, which has become part of our drawing room talks in the upper middle class and the middle class. However, the urban poor does not even know the meaning or doesn't even know what actually this AQI tells us. So I am simply asking you, at your level, you should at least know that which is the authority which publishes this air quality index. So is it the CPCB? Is it the Ministry of Environment? Is it ISRO or is it NIRI? So answer here is CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, which is the main regulatory authority when it's come to any issue dealing with air pollution. So anywhere you read about air pollution and a regulatory body regarding it has been asked, probably in most of the cases the answer would be CPCB, because it is the main authority. Next question. So the state of Kerala has not appointed chairman of the State Human Rights Commission. So you may know that there is a National Human Rights Commission at the central level, and every state has a State Human Rights Commission. Okay, so I am simply asking you, state of Kerala has not been able to create a State Human Rights Commission chairman. However, I am asking you, who is the present chairperson of National Human Rights Commission? Is it Amit Shah? Is it Arun Kumar Mishra? Is it Ranganath Mishra? Or is it A.M. Khanwalkar? So answer here is B, Arun Kumar Mishra, who is actually a retired Supreme Court judge, because as per the NHRC Act, so NHRC, yeah, National Human Rights Commission, is a statutory body, not a constitutional or executive body. It's a statutory body, and as per law, the chairman or head of the NHRC should be a retired Supreme Court judge. And as of now, Arun Kumar Mishra is the present chairperson of NHRC. Ranganath Mishra is actually right now was the first chairperson of NHRC back in the year 1992-93. A.M. Khanwalkar is actually the present Lokpal of India. Ombudsman or Lokpal is the same thing. Amit Shah, as you know, is the Ministry of Home and Cooperative Affairs right now. Next question. The famous Mahakaleshwar temple is situated in which of the following cities of India? A hint, Mahakaleshwar is also known as the Mahakal temple. So I am asking you, where is this Mahakaleshwar temple located? Is it in Bhubaneswar? Is it in Indore? Is it in Mathura? Or is it in Ujjain? So if you have visited this place, a very beautiful place, a very big pilgrimage center also, it is located in the city of Ujjain in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Next question. So now there was certain one to news about defamation in today's newspaper. So I thought, let's make a legal question also. So consider the following statement about defamation in India and identify the incorrect statement. So you have to tell me which of the following statement is incorrect. So first, it defamation is a civil wrong or a tort and a criminal offense in India. Second, the Supreme Court has struck down criminal defamation as unconstitutional, which means it does not exist now or it is not applicable. Third, defamation laws aims to protect an individual's reputation and honor. That is the main objective. And fourth, both spoken and written statements can constitute defamation. So you have to tell me which of them is incorrect. So answer here is B, actually, because defamation is actually still a civil wrong, a tort, as well as a criminal offense under the IPC. And actually, the Supreme Court in a case in 2016, Subramaniam Swami and others. So interestingly, in this case of 2016, Subramaniam Swami, who is a big BJP leader, as well as Rahul Gandhi, both of them were parties to this case. Reason being, they were asking that criminal defamation should be removed from the statute book, because it is causing a unnecessary restriction on the right to freedom of speech and expression, which is a constitutional right. However, the Supreme Court said that criminal defamation in the present form is actually does not violate any kind of rights, and it is actually required to protect an individual reputation and honor. So by this explanation, I hope I have been able to explain A, B, and C. Let's look at the D also. Both spoken and written statement can constitute defamation. So as you may know, if you are stating something defamatory, that is also covered is punishable under defamation. And if you are writing something, that is also defamation. So spoken is said as slander in legal term. If you defaming someone by speaking something, then it is slander, and written statements are punishable as libel or libel. Okay, so answer for us 9th is actually B. Next question, with the objective to ease the voting process, the Election Commission of India provides vote for home facilities to different categories of citizens. So citizens who are not in best of their health or in best of the condition to come and vote for their preferred choice of political parties, Election Commission of India actually provides vote for home facilities to certain categories of citizens. So one category on which it is decided is the age factor. So I'm asking you, as per the present norms for the upcoming Lok Sabha 2024 election, at what age does a person become eligible for vote for home facilities? So is it 18 years, is it 21 years, is it 72 years, or is it 85 years? So answer here is D, that from this 2024 cycle, it is now 85 years. So if you are above 85 years and you fill a form 12D to Election Commission of India, then the Election Commission of India would send an official to your house to register your vote if you are above 85 years. So this facility has been provided. However, in the 2019, it was only 8 years. So now it has been increased to 85 years. So now if you are above 85 years, then you will get it. And please look forward to the Hindu News analysis, because in that I'm going to discuss all the other categories which are provided this with vote for home facilities. Next question. So World Health Day is celebrated every year on which of the following days? So if you will read today's Hindu newspaper editorial pages, so there are a total of, if I'm not wrong, 5 articles, and all the 5 articles are actually related to health and the importance of World Health Day. So my question is very simple: when do we celebrate World Health Day every year? Also remember that these kind of questions can come up and do come up in your CLAT exam and your ALET exam and in all your OLET exams also, or other law entrance test also. So that's why these kind of questions or these kind of days and dates you should remember. So World Health Day is celebrated on April 6th, 7th, 8th or 9th. Today is April 8th. However, it is celebrated on April 7th. So for example, other questions can be, what was the theme of World Health Day today? So if you know the theme of World Health Day for the year 2024, you can mention in the comment or wait for today's Hindu News analysis. Next is, so National Crime Records Bureau is the repository of crime-related data in India. NCRB function under which ministry? So now again, you have received one information or one fact from the question also. So NCRB is the repository of crime-related data. So if I ask you which authority keeps all the crime-related data, the answer would be NCRB. So now another fact which can actually come up as a question has been provided to you. Now I'm asking, NCRB functions under which ministry? So is it Ministry of Home Affairs? Is it Ministry of Law? Is it Ministry of Social Justice? Or is it Ministry of Defense? So answer here is Ministry of Home Affairs, which is actually responsible for national or interstate also at some level for protection of law and order. Yeah, for maintenance of law and order, that would be the correct way to state. So it is responsible for maintenance of law and order at the national level, and usually it is the state government and state police which is responsible for intrastate law and order issue. Next question, which country has the highest number of suicides in the world? So again, there was one article in this editorial page of Hindu, and I'm asking you simply the question, which country has the highest number of suicides in the world? Is it Afghanistan, China, India or US? So the answer here is C, India. India has the highest number of suicides in the world as per the current data. So if you will read today's editorials of Hindu newspaper, you would be able to easily answer these questions. Next, which of the following is the first state in India to pass a Right to Health Act, implementing the right to health to every citizen of it, every inhabitant of its state? So is it Assam, Bihar, Rajasthan or Tamil Nadu? So it was in news last year very much. It has again come up in news because yesterday was World Health Day, and this again was provided that it is the first state which has actually passed a law providing for right to health to all its inhabitants. Next question, which platform developed by the Election Commission of India streamlines permission for political parties and candidate during elections? So in very short, I'll explain you. So if you know model code of conduct, it is currently enforceable right now. So all the political parties and candidates have to follow the MCC. So let's say if you want to do a public meeting, you actually require permission from Election Commission of India. And earlier you actually required a written permission. You had to go personally to the election commissioner office or their representative in your constituency, and therein he or she would be providing you a written permission. However, because of digital age, everything has been digitalized, and now you can actually apply to one of the portal of the Election Commission of India to get such kind of permission. And as I am asking you the name of that platform. So is it Campaign Management System Portal? Is it Suvidha Portal? Is it Election Manifesto Generator? Is it Voter Registration App? So answer here is B, Suvidha Portal, wherein the candidates and political parties can ask for permission if they want to take any public action in their constituencies. Next question, which campaign by the Election Commission of India urges young and first time voters to come to the polling station to vote? So again, on the election page at the top of the on top of the 8th or 9th page of Hindu newspaper, you will find that the Election Commission of India started a campaign this year so that new age voters or people who have just turned 18, because 18 is the voting age in India, that this campaign is going to ask them to come out to vote. So which campaign is it? Is it Turning 18 campaign? Is it You Are the One campaign? Is it Vote Now campaign? Or is it Election Awareness campaign? So answer here is A, Turning 18 campaign launched by Election Commission of India. Next question, which city port, one of the busiest harbors in the US, faced a spotlight due to the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge on March 26th? So Francis Scott Key Bridge, it was broken because it got hit by one of the cargo ship who lost control on it. So I'm asking you simply, where is this bridge located? So is it in New York? Is it in Los Angeles? Is it Seattle? Or is it Baltimore? So answer is Baltimore or Baltimore, in which this key bridge is located. Next question. So the Tata Group has partnered with Taiwan's Power Chip Semiconductor Manufacturing Corporation to set up a 300mm wafer fabrication plant in which Indian state? So wafer fabrication is one of the stages when it's come to semiconductor manufacturing. So recently Tata Group has joined and partnered with a Taiwanese company to set up this platform in which Indian state? That is the question. So is it in Assam, Punjab, Gujarat or Rajasthan? And the answer here is Gujarat. And an additional information, that an assembly plant is being created or being developed in both the states of Punjab and Gujarat relating to semiconductor manufacturing. Second last question for today, which of the following Lok Sabha elections saw the maximum participation of women candidates? So today in the Hindu newspaper, again, there is what certain graph which has come up, certain data points have come up, wherein the participation of women in elections in India has been put up on a graph. So I'm simply asking you, which is the Lok Sabha election in which the maximum participation of women candidates took place? Was it in the 1952 election, the first elections of Lok Sabha? Was it the second, 1957? Was it somewhere in between 1992, or was it the last election, 2019? So answer here is D, 2019, in which there was the maximum number of women candidates as well as there was the maximum number of women participation or representation in the Lok Sabha also, or in the parliament also, at 14.2%. Now let's look at the last question. So which organization spearheads the initiative Education and Sports for All, aimed at providing education and sports opportunities to children in India, particularly those from disadvantaged groups? So this is an initiative by one of our private groups in India, Education and Sports for All. So you have to tell me, which group is it? Is it Tata? Is it Infosys? Is it Oxfam? Or is it Reliance Foundation? So answer here is Reliance Foundation. And I'll ask you this because yesterday in a Mumbai Indians match, actually this foundation took up 18,000 children to the stadium to watch that match. So that's why this has been asked from the sports section today. So class, that's it for today. I hope to see you in the next session of 20 GK question with new question. Thank you and have a very nice day.